Hey, what's up, travelers? In this video, we're visiting one of the oldest temples in Thailand, Wat Pho, with one of the most impressive statues you will ever see in your life. So check it out. So one of the things you gotta look out for when you come to Wat Pho are the tuk-tuk drivers. Because they will scam you. I mean, their scam is a terrible scam. They just try to, usually they'll tell you that this place isn't open when it really is, and then they offer you a deal to go around to three other temples, and then usually it ends up actually being free, but you have to stop at a jewelry shop or a tailor, and that turns into super high pressure sales. Keep that in mind when you're coming to this area. It's not closed no matter how much they tell you it is.
Wat Pho is one of Bangkok's oldest temples. It was built prior to King Rama establishing Bangkok as the capital of Thailand. The name refers to the monastery of the Bodhi tree in Bodh Gaya, India, where Buddha is believed to have attained enlightenment. However, the date of the construction of the old temple and its founder are unknown. In 1788, King Rama I ordered the construction and renovation of the old temple site of Wat Pho, which had by then become dilapidated. During construction, Rama I also set out on a project to remove Buddha images from abandoned temples in Ayutthaya, as well as other sites in Thailand, and many of these retrieved Buddha images were kept at Wat Pho. These include the remnants of an enormous Buddha image from Wat Pho Si Samphret, destroyed by the Burmese in 1767, and these were incorporated into a chedi in the complex. The 80,000 square meters temple grounds contain four great chedis, which hold the remains of four of the Thai kings. 91 small chedis, 71 of which contain the remains of members of the royal family, and 20 of them contain relics of the Buddha. Wat Pho is also the location of the first state-sponsored university in Thailand. It is said to be where the Thai massage was invented. Thank you. Pra-Uposatha is the ordination hall, the main hall used for performing Buddhist rituals, and the most sacred building of the complex. It was constructed by King Rama I in the Ayutthaya style, and later enlarged by King Rama III. Inside this beautiful temple is a golden crystal three-tiered pedestal topped with a gilded Buddha made of gold-copper alloy. And over the statue is a nine-tiered umbrella representing the authority of Thailand. The Buddha image, known and thought to be from the Ayutthaya period, was moved here by Rama I from Wat Salasina in Thonburi. Rama IV later placed some of the ashes of Rama I under the pedestal of the Buddha image so that the public may pay homage to both Rama I and the Buddha at the same time. The four great pagodas of the four monarchs are elegantly situated on the west sanctuary. They are royal pagodas of the first four kings, which were built in different periods. The middle pagoda is decorated with green tile mosaics, is the great pagoda of King Rama I, and it was built during the temple's reestablishment under his reign. Located to the north, the white tile mosaic pagoda is King Rama II's pagoda. In the south, the yellow tile mosaic pagoda represents King Rama III. Both the great pagodas of King Rama II and King Rama III were built during the temple's grand restoration under the reign of King Rama III. The dark blue tile mosaic pagoda represents King Rama IV, is located behind King Rama I pagoda. It is constructed during the repair and maintenance of the temple under King Rama IV's reign.
Thank you.
Reclining Buddha were built by Rama the Third in 1832. The image of the reclining Buddha represents the entry of Buddha into Nirvana and the end of all reincarnations. The posture of the image is referred to as Syasayas, the posture of sleeping or reclining lion. The figure is 15 meters high and 46 meters long, and it is one of the largest Buddha statues in Thailand. It is composed of a brick core, which was modeled and shaped with plaster, then gilded. The right arm of the Buddha supports the head with tight curls, which rest on the two box pillows encrusted with glass mosaics. The soles of the feet of the Buddha are 3 meters high and 4.5 meters long and inlaid with mother of pearl. They are each divided into 108 arranged panels, displaying the auspicious symbols of which Buddha can be identified, such as flowers, dancers, white elephants, tigers, and altar accessories. At the center of each foot is a circle representing a chakra.
The tour of Wat Pho and the Great Reclining Buddha. Yeah, I know, no food in this one, but this is a place that you gotta come to and check out whenever you're in Bangkok. It is just that important of a thing to do, so I figured I might as well make a video about it. If you've enjoyed this video, give me a like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell, and have a great one, and we'll see you in the next one.